Buongiorno ragazzi, questa breve video lezione è intesa a correggere i compiti che avevate per oggi, quindi le pagine 64 e 65 del vostro libro di testo. Dopodiché vi assegnerò il lavoro successivo da fare. Settimana scorsa vi ho assegnato degli esercizi da svolgere online di ripasso sui futuri. Non mi sono arrivate segnalazioni di dubbi o problemi, quindi questo immagino significhi che i futuri sono chiari, quindi la differenza tra will, going to, present continuous non vi dà problemi. Appunto, non avendo ricevuto domande specifiche, immagino che tutto sia chiaro. Correggiamo quindi il compito assegnato per oggi. A pagina 64, la lead in activity diceva: Look at the photos and the title of the article. Discuss the questions: What do you know about the people? What are they famous for? What do you think the text is about? And which of the words and phrases below do you expect to see in the text? Questo è il classico esercizio che vi avrei fatto fare, a voce. So, what do you know about the people? You might know, I don't know, maybe Michael Phelps, maybe Keira Knightley or Richard Branson. Non c'è una risposta giusta o una sbagliata. What do you know about them? You may know Michael Phelps is a famous swimmer, Keira Knightley, a famous British actress, whatever. So each answer might be correct. Number two, what do you think the text is about? So judging from the title, different, not less, might be about overcoming difficulties, maybe. But again, number two is an open answer. Sia la 1 che la 2 sono risposte aperte, ognuno poteva esprimere il proprio parere. Number three, which of the words and phrases below do you expect to see in the text? Again, do you expect to see? So, what do you think? Again, it was open to you. Number two, read and listen to the text and check your ideas in exercise 1. Quindi leggi e ascolta. Spero che alcuni di voi, se non tutti voi, siate riusciti anche ad ascoltare il brano. So, exercise 3 on page 64, exam focus. Read the text again and answer the question number 1. Who helped Michael Phelps to become a better swimmer? His mother helped him. Number two, how many Olympic gold medals did he win? He won 28 gold medals. Number three, what are Dr. Temple Grandini's books about? These books are all about autism. Number four, when did she first become interested in animals? She became interested in animals when she worked on a farm one summer. Number five, why did the other children laugh at Keira Knightley when she was at school? They laughed at her because she had dyslexia. Number six, why was it important for her to learn to read well? Because she wanted to become an actress, and so she had to read scripts. Number seven, why did Richard Branson's teachers think he wasn't very clever? Because he had dyslexia. And eight, what did his head teacher predict? Correctly, he correctly predicted that he would become a millionaire. Okay. Now focus on words and nouns and verbs. Number four, page 65. Look at the words in blue in the text and match them with the definition. Take control of a difficult situation, get over, get better, improve. Number three, bully. Number four, a mentor. Number five, concentrate. Number six, expert. Number seven, encouraged. Number eight, struggled with. Number five, now fill in the gaps with a word in exercise four, then complete the sentences in your own words. I find it difficult to concentrate on my homework when. E qui ognuno di voi avrà scritto qualcosa che vada bene. So, I find it difficult to concentrate on my homework when the TV is on. Number two, the best way of dealing with someone who bullies you is to talk to an adult or whatever you have chosen. Number three, the school subject I struggle with the most is, I don't know, maths, physical education. Number four, a good way to encourage students to work harder is, I don't know. Okay, I don't know what you might have put, what your idea is, maybe. To work harder is, I don't know, to give prizes, to give. I don't know. I don't know. What did you put? I'm curious about your opinion. Number five. Sorry. My English has improved since beginning of this term because I have studied more, because I have been to England, because I have done more exercise, whatever. Number six. I'd like to become an expert on, I don't know, up to your opinion. Then, exercise 7, word store 5e, 4 and off. Complete the phrases in word store 5e with 4 and off. Quindi, word store 5e. off. Word store 5e, page 11. Make fun of someone. Get over a difficulty with the support of someone, somebody, to be or to become a professor of something, to have or to find a passion for something, to dream of something, to make the mistake of doing something. Ok. Ne approfitto per ricordarvi che lo fa il word store 5 è da fare tutto, quindi 5A, B, C, D and E. Per chi non lo avesse ancora completo. Ok, spero che questa correzione che ho cercato di fare in modo molto veloce sia chiara. Ripeto, non avendo avuto particolari segnalazioni riguardo agli argomenti da svolgere la settimana scorsa, immagino che tutto sia chiaro, quindi posso assegnarvi il compito per venerdì. Per venerdì, a pagina 264, leggerete la spiegazione del first e dello zero conditional. Quindi vi leggete tutta la pagina 264, leggete e cercate di capire. La spiegazione termina a pagina 265, dove c'è until, when, providing that e unless. In più farete a pagina 265 gli esercizi numero 1, 2 e 3, che poi correggeremo insieme venerdì. Venerdì, oltre a ricapitolare le conditional clauses, dovrei anche introdurvi le relative clauses, che fanno sempre parte dell'unità 5. Ripeto, se ci sono dubbi, se ci sono cose poco chiare, chiedete, mandate messaggi, mandate mail, qualunque cosa, purché tutto sia chiaro. Vi ringrazio per l'attenzione e a venerdì con la prossima video lezione. Ciao ciao!